Hey, welcome to Sound Selection, and today we're going to figure out what makes a sour type beat. Sour is the debut studio album from Olivia Rodrigo, star of the descriptively named show, High School Musical, The Musical, The Series. Production on this entire project is handled by one man, Daniel Nigro. The sound of this album is roughly split in two. The first are slow ballads like Driver's License, and the second is pop rock like Good For You, and that's the one we're going to look at because I just think it's more exciting. The three songs I've picked are Good For You, Deja Vu, and Brutal. Two of them are mega hits, which means there should be something useful here. So let's see what makes a sour type beat and test those ideas on a new instrumental that would fit on this album. Good For You was the third single from this album, and I think the intro and chorus here give us a layout of the sound we can go for. It's gotta be good pop rock if it's been catching heat for sounding like Paramore's Misery Business. The song opens in the first verse with a solo bass guitar.
Good for you, I guess you moved on really easily. You found a new girl and it only took a couple weeks. Remember when you said that you wanted to give me the world?
This sounds like the sort of bass guitar you would find in any pop rock band. It plays a small melody with the notes F sharp, E, and D. At the end it goes down to C sharp, which sounds weird because that earlier D feels like it's the last note, but then the bass goes one half step lower. These notes match up with the guitar that comes in as the first verse continues.
Good for you, I guess that you've been working on yourself. I guess the therapist I found for you, she really helped. Now you can be a better man for your brand new girl.
The guitar here sounds like it also mostly plays F sharp and E, and at the very end drops down to D and then C sharp. It plays in a regular eighth note pattern, contrasting that more complex rhythm in the bass.
Good for you, I guess that you've been working on yourself. I guess the therapist I found for you, she really helped.
Since this guitar follows the bass, it also sounds uneasy as the notes continue to go down throughout the loop. There are some other things going on at the end of this verse that help build into the chorus, like the white noise sweep and repeated snare.
Therapist I found for you, she really helped. Now you can be a better man for your brand new.
The riser starts first, slowly increasing the volume on some white noise. Then a snare drum plays increasing the loud 16th notes until everything drops out 4 beats before the chorus. Both of these building sounds emphasize that the chorus is coming, and the short bit of silence gives some contrast so that when it comes in, it hits even harder. First, there are those in-your-face guitars with a bunch of distortion. To get close to the same sound, I heavily distorted 2 slightly different guitars and put 1 on the left and 1 on the right. That way the guitar would sound like it's all around you. Also, I'm working with a fake computer guitar here and not a real one. It only plays 3 chords, D, A, and E, and also a tiny F-sharp accent that doesn't really count. If the song is in the key of A major, that makes this a pretty simple 4-1-5 chord progression. 3 chords is a pretty small number, and they're all major, which gives this song that generally happy feeling. The drums in the chorus now use the entire drum kit. There's a snare on beats 2 and 4, and a kick playing on 8th notes. There's a crash hi-hat on the downbeat, and maybe another more subtle hi-hat playing 8th notes. There's a bass in this chorus too, but honestly I can't make out what kind of bass it is. I think it's safe to assume it's still that same bass guitar sound. You can make out the notes though. They're different from the verse, but only because the guitar chords are different too. The bass is still following the root notes of the chords, now playing D, A, and E. After this is another verse, chorus, and a bridge, but I think we've got a good look at how the bass, guitar, and drums all come together on the song. Let's take a break and relax a little bit with Deja Vu. This track is barely pop rock, but there are some instruments we can look at here that give the song a different character. It opens with a low-key melody in the first verse.
Car ride to Malibu, strawberry ice cream, one spoon for two and trade.
This is similar to that opening in Good For You, but instead of a bass guitar, it's something like a toy piano. It alternates between 2 sets of 2 notes that seem to match up with the D and A major chords. It sounds like the song is also in the key of A major, making this a 4-1 chord progression, with both of them major. These songs on this album seem to have two different ways of filling the bass line. The first was that groovy bass guitar on Good For You, and if we jump to the pre-chorus on Deja Vu, we get the second, this long and flat synth bass.
Tell her that we did that too. She thinks it's special, but it's all reused. That was our place.
The bass here sounds like a synth that holds out the notes D, A, and B, mostly matching up with those chords in the melody. Notice how it slides a little between the notes. That's going to show up again later. After the pre-chorus is the chorus, and the last thing I want to look at in the song. I said this track is barely pop rock, and there's something I want to cover here that isn't a guitar, this sliding, distorted synth. This sounds like a synth playing a single sine wave with a bunch of distortion. It seems to slide an octave, playing C sharp and then another C sharp. After doing this twice, it switches to sliding between different octaves of A. The song keeps going into another verse, chorus, and a bridge, but these synths in Deja Vu are some ways to add variety to that pop rock sound. Finally, we get back to something aggressive with the track Brutal. It has some of the same sounds as Good For You, but also mixes things up. The song opens with a bit of a fake out, pretending to be a string ballad. This only lasts for a few seconds before the song really starts. We're blasted with a distorted electric guitar similar to Good For You. To recreate the sound, I did the same thing as that earlier track, panning two slightly different electric guitars. For the most part, it plays a single B major chord, although it gets a little bit weird at the end of each bar. This is kind of similar to those moving synths on Deja Vu, except this time it's guitar chords that are sliding down. As the chord moves, it sounds weird because the notes don't match up with the rest of the song. It starts on a B major chord and ends on an A major chord, both of which fit into the E major key of the song. But that chord in between has notes that don't. We can see what happens to this guitar part if we move all the notes into that E major key. It does sound cleaner, but the abrasiveness that we lost from the old chords really fit with the song. That sliding feeling is also gone too. After this electric guitar intro, the song goes into the first verse, where a different guitar plays the same chords.
I'm so insecure, I think that I'll die before I drink, and I'm so caught up in the news of who likes me and who hates you.
Since these are those same chords, we can go ahead and jump to the chorus, where the heavy guitar comes back in. That guitar from the beginning is now playing the chords A, E, and B, making a 4-1-5 chord progression. These three major chords matches the amount of major chords also used on Good For You. There's also an A sharp chord where the guitar drops a half step. Again, it's not quite in the key of the song, but it's a good transition between those other chords. This chorus also adds a live drum kit. There's a snare on beats 2 and 4, and a kick on just about every 8th note. The cymbal sounds include a crash on the downbeat, an open hat, and maybe some kind of tambourine. After this is another verse and chorus, but we've covered most of what happens in the song. It's pretty short. The guitar here has a similar sound to Good For You, but the chords mix things up by moving in interesting ways. Now that we've looked at these three tracks from Sour, let's recap what we found before starting a new instrumental that would fit on this album. In the intro and verse, they play light melodies, while the chorus switches them out for heavy and distorted chords. There were usually only three major chords, although they sometimes briefly move in weird sounding half steps. Other sounds can also appear in this melodies, like a distorted synth or keyboard. The drums come from a live drum kit. They really don't play anything at the beginning and just build energy into the chorus, maybe with some risers or repeated hits. In the chorus, they play a strong rhythm with the snare and kick. The cymbals mark the downbeat with a crash and also play something constant like a hi-hat or tambourine. The bass could be a live bass or a synth. It shows up in the first verse and pretty much follows whatever chords the guitar is playing. The speed of these songs is on the faster side, between 120 and 180 beats per minute. Now that we have something to work with, let's test out these ideas by making a new, sour, type beat. The songs we looked at start with a subdued melody, so this beat opens the same way. This electric guitar is playing two notes from two different major chords, D and A. The chorus can reuse this same guitar sound. We just need to add some distortion and remove the filter taking out the high frequencies. As this first verse keeps going, more sounds are introduced to build into the chorus. The guitar melody keeps playing those same chords until right before the chorus, where instead they start going down in half steps, and briefly leave the A major key of the song. This chromatic drop gives an unsettling feeling that helps the build into the chorus. This part of the verse is where the bass comes in. It plays a groove like the live bass on Good For You, but the instrument is a flat synth bass, like Deja Vu. The notes it plays fit into the guitar chords. A bit of percussion also comes in right before the chorus drops to help build anticipation. There's a riser followed by some snare drums. This verse keeps adding sounds until two beats before the end, where everything drops out and then the chorus hits. Right away, you get hit with that distorted electric guitar. I tried to capture the same feeling as Good For You or Brutal. The sound comes from two slightly different guitars, one put to the left and one put to the right. They only play D, A, and E major chords, with some catchy strumming. Those little breaks in the guitar pattern really seem to help the groove. At the end, I also added in those sliding chords, where they move down in a chromatic sequence that goes partially out of the key. The drums in the chorus are samples from a regular live drum kit. There's a snare on beats 2 and 4, and a kick on different eighth notes. The hi-hats include a crash on the downbeat, an occasional open hat at the end, and a tambourine, because I wanted to use a tambourine. The bass here is the same sound as the intro. Since it's buried in the background, it plays a less catchy rhythm and just holds out the root notes of the guitar chords. The chorus continues like this for 8 bars, enough for the guitar part to loop 2 times. After this, the chorus plays again, and this time with the final part of the beat added for some variety. This new sound is a synth playing a sine wave with a bunch of distortion. It slides between different notes. The first two are in the guitar chords, and the second two just sounded good. That wraps up this new beat made with the sounds used on Olivia Rodrigo's Sour. It matches the pop rock sound, but adds a little bit of variety with those chords moving in half steps and distorted synths. Hopefully you can incorporate some of these ideas into your own music, or just listen to this album a little bit differently. Thanks for listening. I couldn't get to everything, so let me know what you like about your favorite song on this album. Make sure to subscribe to Sound Selection on YouTube, check out the podcast, and follow on Instagram.